good. Amen. And he has been faithful to me. And I believe that he is faithful to you. Hallelujah. And the Lord has kept you well. Amen. We've been reading from our series. We've been reading from our series on the bread that satisfies. And our scripture, our primary scripture has been in John 6. And you can read from 48 where we say, I am the bread of life. And he says, your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread which comes down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. And he says, I am the living bread which came from down from heaven. If any man of this eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I give for the life of the world. That has been our basic scripture that I've been using as we have been speaking about the bread that satisfies. And all the series that are past, we've been talking about the secrets of the heart. But now, I want us to look at something else as we speak of the bread that satisfies today. And I want us to go ahead and look at our topic today in that series. We are calling it the children's bread. The children's bread. Amen. You know, every dream of a parent, every dream of a father or mother and mother is to be able to provide for their children. It is to give them a welfare, to give them prosperity, to make sure that they lack nothing. And one of the things that they look at is their health, both spiritually, I mean socially, physically. It's very key. How is your child growing? How is your child becoming? And one of the things that even we take these children, even to the hospital, is to be checked, to make sure that they're in good health. And to give them, to make them in good health, they are provided with food, good food. Children who are not well fed, you'll find they may have problems, they may have diseases, sicknesses, they may have imbalances. But God is the beginner and the author of all these things. He is the one who is very concerned about his children. He is the one very concerned about their welfare, about their health, both soul-wise, their minds, even their body. How healthy are they? And so I would like us to look at scripture from Mark 7, 25 to 30. Mark 7, 25 to 30. And it talks of a Greek woman, a Phoenician woman, whose young daughter had an unclean spirit, and she heard of Jesus, and he came to him. You know, when your daughter or your child is with an unclean spirit, you can imagine what this woman was going about. Because this child was oppressed and tormented. And this daughter needed help, needed healing. Hallelujah. And if you read well from the other scriptures, she came to Jesus. And she came crying out, Jesus, son of David. She came crying out, have mercy on me. But Jesus never turned. Jesus never spoke. Until his disciples said, can you send this woman away? Hallelujah. And the Bible says, this woman, who was a Greek Syrophenician by nation, she besought him that he would cast forth the devil out of her daughter. Amen. And she came by faith. And Jesus spoke to her. Let's read verse 27. Mark 7, 27. But Jesus said unto her, let the children first be filled, for it is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. This is what Jesus answered her. That woman, let the children first be filled. For it is not good to take that which belongs to the children, the children's bread, and cast it unto dogs. I don't know if it was you, what you tell Jesus. Because this woman, God had given her some wisdom, some revelation. And she answered and said to Jesus, verse 28, yes, Lord. She said, yes, it's true. Yes, the dogs under the table eat the children's crumbs. Hallelujah. And Jesus said unto her, for this saying, go thy way, the devil is gone out of thy daughter. And she was come to her house, she found the devil gone out, and her daughter had laid upon the bed. This woman came, but she was not an Israelite. And she was not offended. Jesus said, what I have belongs to the children. What I have is the children's bread. Meaning that healing is a bread to the children. To the children of God. Hallelujah. It is a healing. And when I talk of healing, we are talking of healing of all perspectives, all dimensions. We are talking of the healing of the spirit, healing of the soul, and healing of the body. He is talking of the healing of the mind. There are people who are not sick in the body, but they are sick in the mind. The decisions they make, the things they say, the things they do, you find they are sick in the mind. There are people who are sick in the heart, their heart broken. Their relationships have been broken. They have pain of the heart. They are feeling rejected. They are feeling they are not loved. They are feeling oppressed in their heart. Their heart broken. Others are sick in the body. You find they have now physical, natural sicknesses, which are sicknesses we call like malaria and other sicknesses. Others have typhoid and all every other kind of sicknesses. But also we have other sicknesses, which are demonic sicknesses. Sicknesses which, after going to the hospital, they are tested and you find nothing. Doctors tell you all the tests you have carried, you seem okay, but you still have pain, but you still have discomfort. There are sicknesses that are never found because they are actually demonic. There's a spirit, demonic spirit, behind it. So what am I saying? That this woman came because she needed help. But Jesus tells her, what I have is for the children. What I have is the bread. God has a bread for his children. Now this bread brings healing. This bread ensures that they are in welfare. It ensures that they're in good health, in their mind, in their spirit, and their body. When they eat this bread, they are healthy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But this bread is reserved for his children. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And in this case, this woman was not offended because she knew that the Gentiles were defined as dogs by the Jews. And Jesus, when he came, by the time he came, he was sent only to the Israelites. He came with a body. The body was made through a Jew. Hallelujah. It was made from Mary. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It was made through Mary. This body was not made from Mary, but it was made, created, and put in Mary's womb. So when Jesus was born, he was refined as a Jew. Hallelujah. And lived as a Jew. And that time, God had commanded that the Jews be separate. And the Gentiles were defined as dogs because they were worshippers of idols. They were worshippers of other gods. Hallelujah. So when Jesus refined to her and said that you cannot give this bread to the children, to the dogs, not necessarily Jesus was against the woman. But what he was saying, the bread I have is for the children of God, not for the unbelievers. This bread is for the children of God. It's for them who have believed in God. It's for them who are born through Abraham. Because Abraham had a covenant with God, and the children of Israel were the children of God. Hallelujah. So it was not about her. Jesus wanted to teach. Jesus was saying, I have come for the Jews, and I've come for the believers. Hallelujah. And what I have, I bring to the children of God. Hallelujah. In other words, those who believe in a true God, those who believe in my Father. Hallelujah. Gentiles have no right to receive from God. Hallelujah. Because they were sinners, they had gone against God, and they were worshiping other God. Remember, God has said, worship no other God but me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because they were under the Abrahamic covenant, and so they were defined as the children of God. At the time Jesus came, hallelujah, the Jews rejected the Messiah. And when they rejected the Messiah, thank God, because if they received the Messiah, they would not have killed him. Hallelujah. But it's through his death and resurrection that you have found salvation, that you have grafted him into the olive tree, which is the original olive tree, which is the Israel. For us as Gentiles, we came in when the true olive oil rejected the Messiah, the olive tree rejected the Messiah. And the Bible says you are plucked in, glory to God. And so when they rejected the Messiah, they killed him, he died and rose again. And from that day, he was now given out for the Gentiles. Salvation came to the Gentiles. And so the Gentiles, me being one, we were unbelievers, we were not Jews. Now we have been given a right to the bread of life. The blood of the children. Hallelujah. Now we can be able. And those are not just all Gentiles. Those who have believed, who has received Jesus Christ. This healing becomes the bread of the children. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But sometimes as children of God, listen to me carefully. Why is it that sometimes the children of God not receive? Why is it that the believers, somebody comes who is not even a believer, like this woman? Because there were many people in the time of Jesus who were healed and others were not healed. This woman came by faith. She was not a Jew, but she came and received. She came and said, even the small, even the dogs in the crumble. And Jesus said, woman, by your faith you are healed. Your daughter is healed. Go, your daughter is well. Hallelujah. Because what God is looking for is faith. Can you believe God? Many people, you are born again and you have been in church and people have been praying for, they have not been healed. Why? This woman came and she was healed. Yet there are many Israelites who are not healed. As the Bible says in the days of Elijah, that a woman who was a widow is the one who received a miracle in the days of famine. Yet there were many widows in Israel that people were supposed to receive from God. The children of God, they missed out on the opportunity. Hallelujah. Yet a foreigner comes and a Gentile and receives. Now, can I tell you why? One, when she was told she is a dog, she was not offended. Hallelujah. She was not offended. What she needed, she was a miracle. And she knew that is true. But for us, many times, we get offended and we miss out on God. The Pharisees and many Israelites were offended by Jesus. For he called himself, or me called the Son of God. They disputed. They said, this is the son of Joseph. This is the son of Mary. This is a carpenter's son. We know him. How can he be the Messiah? How can he be the Son of God? They were offended. And so they missed up on the healing of God. The bread was theirs. The healing was theirs. But many died in their sin. And many died in their sickness. Yet the Messiah was there. Hallelujah. Though they were intended to be healed, the Bible says Jesus could not do many miracles in his own home country. He went to his own people. He raised hands only a few sick people. We can read from Mark 6 verse 3. They said, is not this the carpenter's son? Is not this the son of Mary? Is not this the son of James? Is not this the son of, his brother not James? His brother is not James and Joseph and of Judah and of Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? They were offended at him. Mark 6 verse 3. They were offended. And I need to read at Mark 6 verse 5. He could there do no mighty work, save he laid his hands upon a few sick folk and he healed them. Only a few people. Yet you have seen Jesus telling this Greek woman that the bread I have is for the children. The bread I have is for the Israelites. The healing I carry is for them. But now they could not receive it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God will not receive you just because you are baptized. You not receive a miracle just because you go to church. But God is saying, can you have faith? Can you believe me? Can you have faith? Amen. Hallelujah. And Bible says that God marvels at the unbelief of the people. Jesus marveled. He wants to heal people. He wanted to do miracles. He wanted to keep them in good health. He wanted to visit them. He said, oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how I would have covered you under my feathers. How I would have kept you. Glory to God. The Bible says, Jesus marveled at their unbelief. Glory to God. Because that's how God does. He marvels at our unbelief. Glory to God. God always wants to do something good for us. God, anytime we come to him, anytime we gather in his name, in our ministry, and he wants to do us good, he wants to revisit us, he wants to heal us. Hallelujah. But sometimes we get offended. In Mark 6:6, he said he marveled because of their unbelief, but he went round about the religious teaching. Even when God marvels at your unbelief, he still wants to teach you. Because through his word, you will get faith. That's why Jesus went about teaching them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But this Greek woman stood by faith. She was persistent. Sometimes when you go to God, we give up very easily. This woman was not an Israelite, but she followed up on Jesus. She kept on nagging and shouting. But then she realized, what can he do? She bowed and worshipped him. Hallelujah. Amen. When you know how to go before God, sometimes you go before God by prayer, but you don't know how to go before God. When you run to go before God in worship, before God in praises, before God in honor, that's why Jesus taught us, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. He starts by worshiping. He starts by praising. He starts by honoring God. exhorting him. Then after that, he says, thy kingdom come. He said, you talk about men of God. You bless them. You pray for them. Hallelujah. And then you say, let your power come down. Glory to God. And then after that is when you say, give us our daily bread. Hallelujah. And then you can say, forgive me. Sometimes we go to God, the first thing we are saying, forgive me my sins. Forgive me my iniquities. You have not even acknowledged that he is God. You have not even exalted him first. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But when we learn to go before God and bless his name, when we learn to go before God and exalt him for who he is, glory to God. Hallelujah. Then he gets his attention. She needed a miracle. She needed the bread of life for her daughter. She knew Jesus. She recognized Jesus as the bread of life. You know, when you go to God, he will give you what you recognize him for. That's why you find the Old Testament. I mean, Abraham said, Jehovah Jireh, because he has an experience with God, a provider. Then he was, they were healed, they said, he's Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals us. When you go before God, you must, it is well, it is good to recognize him, that he is able to do what you are looking for. This woman knew, I'm going to him, who cried, who said, I am the bread of life. I heard him say, he is the bread of life. He is the bread. And when I eat this bread, I get life. When I get eat this bread, I get my healing. When I eat this bread, I'm made whole. Hallelujah. That's how faith is built up. Sometimes you have to read the Bible. But until you recognize something that God said he is, then you are able to receive. Hallelujah. Sometimes you just go through the Bible, we read. But catch your eye. Let your eye catch something that God has said he is. And go to him. And you will get it. Hallelujah. You know that God is saying, I can be able to give you this. That's why when Jesus said, I'm the bread of life and I satisfy. When you eat, you'll not die. What he meant is, all aspects of life that you need. If you need healing, I'll give you. And now here he affirms it by saying, I have the children's bread. And healing is for the children of God. Are you a child of God? You are a candidate for healing. Are you sick in the body? Are you unwell? Jesus can heal you. If you can agree with him, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we see this oftentimes. And believers coming to the church meetings and the crusades, and they receive healing, while the children of God go home with their sicknesses. My God, help us. Hallelujah. Why the unbelief? Because believers sometimes, when you go to church, we get offended. Satan works with offenses. He's the father of offenses. Jesus said, blessed is he who is not offended of me. Sometimes we get offended of Christ that you don't know we are offended. Hallelujah. And when we come to church, sometimes you're offended by men of God. There's one time when I was just born again. I felt very bad because the pastor did not greet me. We met with the pastor and just he passed me by. What I could not know is the pastor's mind was far. Have you ever been offended by the man of God? Have you ever been offended just because you're not given an opportunity to give a testimony? Have you ever been offended just because of something in church? That itself becomes a hindrance to a miracle. Glory to God. When something happens in church, you get offended. Then you broke your way of receiving. Some people are offended because they are called a sinner. Hallelujah. When you are called a sinner, pastor is preaching and he says, you sinner, you need to repent. That is enough to make some people offended. But actually, they are saying the truth. We are all sinners. We depend on the grace of God. It is when we are born again. It's when you are washed. Hallelujah. Bible says, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But some people just being told you are a sinner. Maybe they are not even born again. But because you said, sinners will be saved. It becomes an offense and it stops us from receiving Jesus. And from receiving from God the healing. Glory to God. This woman, when she was saved, that the bread I have is not for dogs. She was not offended. She said, yes, Lord. But even the dogs, they eat the crumbs that fall. And that is why when you find in a crusade, those who are not even born again, they come. They come crying to God. They come believing God. And as they come, the Bible says that they were healed. Glory to God. And even today they are healed. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever. Hallelujah. When people come, they open up and say, they don't care, they are called sinners. They don't care. What they want is, we want to be forgiven. We want to be healed. We want to be delivered. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus says, he is the healing. Healing is the bread for the children of God. We should be healed. We should live a healed life and a life of good health. God is saying, in that house you're saying, as far as I'm alive, as far as I'm the bread of life, the children of God should live a healed life, a life of good health. Hallelujah. That's why he says in the Bible, in Isaiah 53, he says, by his stripes you are healed. Hallelujah. He says, by his stripes we are healed. What does that mean? By his stripes you are healed. We were healed. That's what it says. We are is present tense. We are healed. Meaning every time you walk with God, you are healed. You walk in health. He is not a future tense. And then in 1 Peter 2:24, he says, by his stripes you are healed. So Isaiah says, by his stripes you are healed. Peter says, by his stripes you are healed. If those two people, those two men of God, they are saying healing is not a future. Walking in health is not a future thing. It's something which is a daily. It is past present. Meaning it's something that we need to go by every day. Hallelujah. Every day we should walk in health. Every day we should walk healed. Hallelujah. And that's why Jesus says, I am the bread of life. If you eat this bread, you'll walk in health every day. You walk healed every day. Sickness is not our portion. When Christ was striped, it was to make sure that we walk in health. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The meaning of this, every time, every day you live, you can enjoy good health. What am I trying to say? That it is the will of God for us to prosper in health and in wealth. They go together. Because health is part of wealth. You cannot say you are wealthy. However, a billionaire you are, when you are not healthy in the body. If you are sick and you are in hospital, being put oxygen, and you have billions of money, can you say you are wealthy? I don't believe so. Hallelujah. And that's why the Bible says in 3 John, the book of 3 John 1, verse 2 says, beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Hallelujah. You may prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospereth. How is that possible? By the grace through Jesus Christ. He is saying, I wish that you prosper. Hallelujah. I wish that you walk in good health. I wish you are so prosper. That tells me you can be in good health of the body, but your soul may not be prospering. Your soul may be sick. There are many people who are not in hospital today. They are not taking medicine, but they have souls which are sick. Their emotional life is sick. And they need the bread of life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Others are sick in the mind, as I said earlier. They are not taking any medicine because their body is all right. They eat well, but their minds are sick. You can look at the decisions they make, the things that they eat, the places they go. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Jesus Christ came that we may have superabundant life. A life that is free from sickness. A life that is free from oppression. A life that is free from disease. But Satan is always out there to do the opposite. And that's why I want to teach you about living a life of health. Hallelujah. Satan is out there always to oppose. And he is out there to tell you as a child of God that you can never live a healthy life. I know what it is. There's a time I never thought you can walk healthy. There's a time I thought that you cannot live without sickness. Because Satan had brought and attacked me with sicknesses from one sickness to another. And I would come from this sickness. I remember I had a chest problem, came to fight typhoid, from typhoid to whatever. And I was so lean and thin. And I was saying, is this how people live? And I thought everyone who lives on this planet Earth has a sickness. And that is the preaching of the devil. And I thought it is not possible to walk healthy. I thought it's not possible to live a healed life until I read the scripture and I believed God and we prayed and God came for me and the sicknesses were removed and I started walking until I lived a time without even visiting a hospital. And I said, is it me again that I'm living without sickness or diseases? Hallelujah. You can walk free. So Satan does the opposite and he came to steal, kill and destroy whom we should resist by faith. We should resist the devil by faith. We should resist the gospel of Satan that we have to live in sicknesses. We have to live in medicine. We have to live in pain every time. Because the Bible says Jesus took everything. In Isaiah 53 verse 4, the Bible says he carried our pains. He carried our sicknesses. He carried our sorrows. He carried our griefs. He was considered as him who is smitten by God. But I can tell you for sure, it was for you and me that we may walk a free life, a life which is free of oppression, free of sickness and diseases. John 10:10 says, the thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I'm come that they might have life, and that they may might have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That will come that they may have life, and have life more abundantly. Glory to God. So what am I saying? I'm saying that this is the purpose why Christ came. That's why he declared himself, I am the bread of life. Meaning, I carry all the aspects of life for humanity. Every good thing comes from the Father, and he has given it to us through Jesus Christ. And one of these good things is good health. And when I mean good health, is the health of your spirit, of your soul. When I talk of your soul, emotion, mind, and even your heart, and even the healing of your physical body. Hallelujah. How do we live a healed life and a life of good health? How do we live a healed life and a good health? That's what I'll be taking you through next Sunday. But I want to just say a few things as I just introduce you. One is, many people today are living a life which is full of oppression. They are living a life full of sickness, and especially of the heart. Many people are heartbroken. Many people, if there is sickness that is with the people, it's heartbrokenness. They are injured. They are full of pain. Many people are living with a sickness of mind, and they are oppressed every day, every night. There's a healing, and there's one who can heal you. If you can take this bread, even if you are not a child, you are not born again, Bible is telling us, this woman decided to go to Jesus. She was not a believer, but she was a Greek. But she decided, I better follow Jesus. I can go to Jesus. Even you can say, it doesn't matter where I come from, we believe in Jesus or not. You may be in a religion which does not believe in Christ. But you can say, I am tired of this sickness. I'm tired of this pain. I can run to Jesus and he can heal me. And that's why I'm trying to tell you. This word I'm speaking right now, it is the word that brings healing. Jesus Christ is the word of God that became flesh. The word that he spoke. He is the word. Hallelujah. And you shall see next Sunday. Amen. That God wants his children to live not by the things they eat and the things they live by. We are living at a dispensation where people value what they eat, which is very good. People watch what they eat. Some do not take sugar. Some are taking every time water, lemon, and all concoctions to detoxify, which is very good. But even then, after doing all that, you'll find them still being sick. Why? Because sickness is not just about the body. Sickness, cause of sickness can be demonic, meaning you have eaten every good thing that you need to give your body health. But demons come in and they cause a sickness. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said, man shall not live on bread alone. There is another bread apart from the natural bread. There's a bread that can keep you in perfect health. Apart from the natural bread you eat. The natural bread you eat, some of it has been causing sicknesses. There are some people that are told if you take sugar, you die quickly. Others are told if you take this substance, yet they are natural foods. But God wants us to enjoy natural foods. When you eat the bread, which is Christ, you can enjoy the natural foods. And they not harm you. He says that when you serve me, in Exodus 23, when you serve me, I'll bless your water and your bread. That means, and I remove sicknesses from you. When you serve me, when you recognize that I'm bread of life and I'm bread that satisfies, I'm the bread that heals. When you take me, I'll bless, meaning the water and the bread can cause sickness. The food we eat can cause sicknesses. That's why we are told not to eat this or that. But when you are blessed, you can eat anything and not have problem with you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We have the Bible in Jericho where they had a good city and they had good everything, but the water was bad. It was bringing death until Elisha came and he spoke the word of God. And the water was healed. That which was killing people became healed. And they could enjoy it. And it became sweet water. What am I trying to say? What he spoke was Christ. He is the word that became fresh. We shall be seeing it next time. He is the word that became fresh. He is the bread of life. He is the bread that he gives to the children. He says, this flesh of mine that we have read in John 6 verse 48. He says, the bread I give is my body. is my body, hallelujah. The bread I give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world, hallelujah. When we recognize this, we can live in good health. I want to say, as I finish, that I'll be taking you through the series of the children's bread. Watch and be keen next Sunday that we may continue this journey. And I believe by the end of this journey, you will be able to live a healthy life. God will heal you. But even now, if you have faith, you can believe this word, as this woman believed and say, Jesus, heal me. We have seen by his stripes you were healed, and by his stripes you are healed. Even now, you can get it and receive from the Lord. And I want to pray with you. You can touch where you are healed, you are sick, where you are unwell, as I pray for you. And I believe that God will touch you and heal you. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for my viewer who is saying, I need healing, who has received this word that is the will of God for them, for him or her to walk in good health. Today, in Jesus' name, I rebuke that sickness where she is holding or is holding and claiming this is where it is paining. I command that spirit of infirmity to leave right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And I release healing upon that person. I release healing upon my viewer right now. I command that pain to go not to come back again in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive your healing. Be healed now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be healed of your headaches, be healed of your chest pains, be healed of your leg pains, be healed of every infirmity. In the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you, Father, for the healing, and I release the power of God over them now. Receive your healing in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. If you are not born again, you can run to God and say, I want to be saved. Receive Jesus this hour, and you shall receive healing. When I received Jesus, I was sick, and I got healed without prayer. Because when he comes, he's a bread that heals. So receive this bread and be healed. Say after me, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you, I'm a sinner. Forgive my sins. Cleanse me by your precious blood. Come and be my Lord and my Savior. Today I believe you died and rose again. With all my heart, I believe it. And I confess with my mouth, you are the Lord. And I'm saved. I'm born again. Thank you, Lord. Heal my sickness and set me free in Jesus' name. If you have prayed that prayer, you are born again. And receive your healing right now of your soul, of your spirit, and of your body. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. God bless you so much. See you next Sunday. Shalom, shalom. I'll be taking you through this series. Amen.